Dear students, Namaskar. Today I am here to explain about biochemical theory of life. It is also called Oparin's concept or most accepted theory of origin of life. It was forwarded by Russian scientist Alexander Ivanovich Oparin in 1938. It stated that life originated from non-living inorganic compounds in the ocean of primitive Earth about 3.3 billion years ago. In short, Oparin explained that primitive Earth had water, methane, ammonia, which underwent a series of reactions due to ultraviolet rays of sun, volcano, lightning, and Earth's temperature. As a result, biomolecules like protein, carbohydrate, nucleic acid were formed. Finally, life is originated. Oparin explained his theory in three steps, that is, chemogeny, biogeny, and cognogeny. Chemogeny, synthesis of simple organic molecules is called chemogeny. Elements like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen were abundant on primitive Earth. As Earth cooled, simple molecules like water, methane, ammonia formed by combining elements. As Earth cooled to 100 degrees Celsius, hydrocarbons like acetylene, ethylene were formed. Such formed hydrocarbon reacted with steam and formed aldehydes and ketones. Due to polymerization, oxidation and reduction of above molecules cause simple sugar, ammonia, amino acid, fatty acid formed. Above molecules reacted in hot water of ocean and new molecules like purine, pyrimidine and nucleotides were formed. All these molecules formed in hot water of ocean, so-called hot dilute soup or primordial soup or prebiotic soup. Biogeny, formation of complex self-reproducing biological molecules is called biogeny. Sugar, purine and pyrimidine formed during chemogeny react with phosphate and formed DNA and RNA. DNA and RNA are self-replicating molecules, which is first sign of origin of life. DNA, RNA and hot dilute soap bounded by water and formed Quaker beds. Quaker beds absorb organic soup, then grew in size and multiplied, as a result formed anaerobic heterotrophs or protocell or first cell or protobiont, which is similar to the virus. Protobionts give rise prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Eukaryotics evolve into protozoa, metazoa and metaphyta. Cognogeny, diversification in protozoa, metazoa, metaphyta is called cognogeny. Due to shortage of food in ocean, organism become parasitic, saprophytic, chemosynthesizer, photosynthetic and so on. Thank you.